So I'm going to start a new sketch on the bottom. And I'm going to project some more line work down. And I'm just going to select these edges here. And that gives us this oval shape, which we're going to use to cut through the body of the box. And there's an open edge here. So what I can do here is I can just add an extra little circle that helps me finish out this shape. And that'll help me complete the extrude. So with that, I can now select these two surfaces and I can extrude through our body. So now I can use that as a guide for using either a router bit or even a drill bit to get the majority of that shape bored out. The other thing that we're going to use this box for is for defining how to cut the overall slope and curvature of this shape. So what I'm going to do is start another sketch on the side, create a sketch, and I'm going to do another project. I'm going to project this edge here and here. Deselect that. And I mentioned earlier to just kind of have this box extend over the top. What I'm going to do is to just make a small straight horizontal line here to be able to cap off the rest of that sketch. Do the same thing on the other side. And then I'm going to select this and just extrude through the shape. And that way we have a full cutout. And again, we can run a router bit along the edge here so that we can cut the majority of this shape out. The other thing that we can do with this box is be able to cut the rest of this pocket out. This backside here doesn't have an opening, so we want to be able to use a router bit again on this surface and mount this flat against the table so that we can do the final cuts. So I'm going to start a new sketch, and again, we're going to project this set of planes onto that surface, and that's going to help us draw out the cutout in the box that we need. There we go. And I'm just going to extend this line down. Same thing over here. And I'm going to just extrude this surface here through our template, and that's going to allow us to cut out the rest of the shape.